for you today, our sister Carolyn. And we give you thanks for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our journey on earth. And Lord, we pray that in your boundless mercy you would console those who mourn this day. And let them see, because of what Jesus has done, because he rose victoriously from the grave, that we may see the gate of death as the gate to eternal life, and that we also may continue our course on earth in confidence until by your call, Lord, we are reunited with those who have gone before us. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Amen.
Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the valley, the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. The rod, your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord.
Our eulogy today is written by Carolyn's husband, Raymond, so I share that with you now. Carolyn Joanne Wallace was born on June 25th, 1950, in Missoula, Montana, to Henry and Alma. She was the youngest of five children, which included Barbara, James, David, and Wesley. At the age of seven, Carolyn's mother passed away. The next 2 years, with a lot of help from Barbara, Henry did his best to raise his children as a single father. 1959, Henry married the children's Sunday school teacher, Helen Phelps, who took over the mothering responsibilities for Wesley and Carolyn. Carolyn attended Whittier and Cold Springs Elementary and graduated from Sentinel High School in 1968. She moved to Nampa, Idaho and attended Northwest Nazarene College from 1968 to 1970. In 1970, she married Glenn Bowery. During their marriage, they moved around a bit, living in Spokane, Kansas City, and Yakima. Carolyn was dedicated to getting her college education and she earned a bachelor's degree from Whitworth College and a master's degree in counseling and psychology from Central Washington University. They settled in Spokane, where Carolyn started her lifelong career in helping people. Due to irreconcilable differences, her marriage to Glenn ended in 1978. In 1979, Carolyn married Mike Huntington, who lived in Lacey, Washington. The first of the three greatest blessings of Carolyn's life occurred on May 27, 1980, when Jared Michael was born. 19 months later, the second of the three greatest blessings of Carolyn's life occurred on January 4, 1982, Dennis Nathan was born. They moved to Lodi, California for a few years and then returned to Olympia, Washington. During this time, Carolyn started her career in vocational rehabilitation counseling at the Thurston County Economic Development Council and then with Cascade Rehabilitation. Due to irreconcilable differences, her marriage to Mike ended in 1987. On June 17, 1989, a brand new adventure started. When Carolyn met Rick Wallace in Leavenworth, Washington. Surrounded by family and friends, with Jared, Dennis, and Megan standing up with them, Carolyn and Rick were married on October 4th, 1989, at their home in Tacoma. The third of the three greatest blessings of Carolyn's life occurred on March 24th, 1994, when Derek Charles Apple was born. Carolyn worked as a vocational rehabilitation counselor for Carl 1991 until retirement in January of this year. Over the years, Carolyn had attended several churches in Tacoma until recently finding her church home here at Emmanuel Lutheran Church. Carolyn had several passions and hobbies. She started playing the piano at the age of 7. And this is really cool. Just a few weeks ago, sat down at her piano and filled her home with a beautiful melody, the great Christian hymn that we're going to hear and sing today, Great Is Thy Faithfulness. When Derek left for college, she decided to play the cello and took lessons at the University of Puget Sound. Carolyn was an avid Mariners fan. She'd probably be happy to play well. I mean, they're only 2 out of a wild card. I think it's 2. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. I'm a big sports fan as well. So, avid Mariners fan, she went to several games every year. She also traveled a few times to see Mariners in San Diego in spring training with her baseball partner and prime Jan Sterling. Carolyn belonged to 2 neighborhood women's groups, the Oyster Queens and the Cacklers. And she was an honorary member of the quilting group. 26 years, Carolyn and Rick enjoyed the great meals and company of their friends in their gourmet group, which also included cruises to Mexico and the Caribbean. Carolyn also loved decorating her home. Her most recent draw, the safari theme, resulted in leopard and zebra print carpeting. She loved the colors purple and red, decorating the living room purple with the dining room red. Anyone visiting during Christmas will remember the Christmas tree sitting directly between the 2 rooms, one half decorated in purple, the other half decorated in red. She loved celebrations, birthday, Easter, Thanksgiving, Christmas, lots of food, lots of laughter, lots of games after dessert, and lots of love. Carolyn also loved her Russell Terrier, Griffey. Who's he named after? He was her protector. Anyone who visited was warned not to get too close to Carolyn until Griffey gave approval. Carolyn enjoyed spending time with the family and was blessed when her sister Barbara and husband Phil moved to Gig Harbor. And also in 2010, when her brother Jim, wife Maureen, moved from Missoula to Tacoma. Carolyn's favorite trips were the several visits to Lewiston, Montana to see her parents. Our first family trip to Yellowstone with Jared, Dennis, and Megan. Spring break trip to New Mexico. The surprise trip to spring training in 2013, and cruises with friends to Western Mexico. One of her favorite cruise visits was to Grand Turkey. She fell in love with the feral donkeys that had escaped from the salt mines. One of Carolyn's refrigerator magnets says, I can sympathize with this, what this magnet says. I love not camping. Beach State Park, Wallace State Park in Joseph, Oregon, and the annual Wallace family campouts. Several years of camping with the Goody family and camping trips with Megan's children, Kylie, Jason, and Lily. Carolyn had a servant's heart. She was always willing to provide a helping hand and meal to family and friends in need. In 1996, her mom, Helen, moved from Montana to Tacoma. For 9 years, Carolyn supported her mom with weekly trips to Fred Meyer and the Bon Marché. Carolyn is a great cook. In addition to her favorite dinner dish that she called frickin' chicken, she made an awesome apple pie and unbelievable biscuits and gravy, but most of all, of anything else, Carolyn loved her son. She was very proud of Ben Mandio. She loved how Jared followed his heart and lived his passion for music, playing in several bands and building guitars for a living. She was proud of his strong work ethic and his willingness to help anyone at any time. She loved his honesty, loyalty, compassion, and love for our family. How he loves to play card games, and how his jovial demeanor and infectious laugh brought joy to all. She was grateful of his love for his dog brother, Griffey, and how he was always willing to stay with him when they were gone. The beautiful job he did remodeling the downstairs bathroom and creating an awesome Hawaiian beach team made her very happy. Your mom loves you, Mary, dear Ranger. She loved Dennis's tender heart, free spirit, courage, and strength. She loved how, as a boy, after being sent to his room, he would come downstairs with a heartfelt apology and was sincerely sorry for whatever it is that occurred. And while she missed him dearly, she was glad that he had the opportunity to hop on a plane with his duffel bag for an 18-month stay in Hawaii. She was proud of his perseverance to never give up on his college dream and for his graduation from the University of Washington. Recently for his commitment to a new career. There is no doubt in your mom's mind that you will be successful in whatever you pursue. But most of all, she was proud of you for having the courage and strength to tackle life's challenges, to recognize your potential, to figure out what you needed to change to achieve. Dennis, your mom loves you dearly. She loved Derek's confidence and courage, and that he is a mom's boy. Sorry, I guess we just made that pop up right now. She loved making you chocolate chip pancakes and driving you to school for all 13 years. She loved the courage that you showed in getting through your greatest life challenge when you were a junior in high school. As a side note, she is grateful for the friends that circled around you and carried you through that dark time. She loved that you had the courage to leave home and go to WSU, and especially that you had the courage to return to WSU in January after learning that she is sick. She's proud of you for your growth and maturity over the last 8 months, and for your dependency on God for your strength and courage during your illness and now while we grieve. Your mom knows that you have a lot to offer this world and that there are great things in store for you. She encourages you to go get it done. Derek, your mom loves you dearly. Carolyn's faith, hope, and trust in God is an inspiration. I can vouch for that. During her courageous and hard-fought battle with cancer, Carolyn demonstrated what it means to be a person of faith. From the very start, she put her hope and trust in God and knew ultimately that He was in control. Her faith in God never wavered, and she was never angry about her illness. In the few weeks preceding her passing, she talked of heaven and how it was a perfect place. Pondering the next part of her journey, she said, Can you imagine opening your eyes and seeing Jesus? With family members by her side, Carolyn passed away peacefully at her home on August 8th, 2016. Carolyn leaves us with great memories and filled with the love that she so freely gave to us all. While we miss Carolyn very much, we know that she is in the presence of her Lord and Savior. She no longer has to imagine what it would be like to open her eyes and see Jesus. Thanks be to God.
Find grace to this family and program. the words of this amazing hymn of faith that Carolyn wrote together.
Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war breaks For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set me high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At his sacred tent, I will sacrifice the shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Hear my voice when I call, Lord. Be merciful to me and answer me. My heart says, if you seek his face, your face, Lord, I will seek. And I remain confident of this, that I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. So wait for the Lord. Be strong, take heart, and wait for the Lord.
Here, let's just take a second. Let's look at this woman in front of us. How beautiful she was. Before I go, thank you, Mom, for passing us those things. Before I begin, I'll give you a little background.
Four.
That's an aggressive time right now. Dennis, Mom is the reason we get to call you our brothers. Although times weren't always easy, Mom brought you to Dad, and fate decided that you would be the boys and men that I've been lucky enough to look up to my entire life. Mom endured a great struggle and pain to bring me into this world and to bring your son down. I don't know the exact number, but I know there are many miscarriages before Mom finally brought me into the world at the age of 24. A miracle was an act of blinding faith that allows me to stand before you all today. Mom brought my family together. As I look around at my group of friends and family in front of me right now, I have realized that her love and her light have brought us all together. When I came home this summer, my mom changed my life and what she told me. It's the reason I now choose to be positive, uplifting, and love with a full heart just like her. She said to me, "Derek, what will make me happy during this time is watching you living freely and loving those around you wholeheartedly." Since that moment, I have not looked back, and I will stop at nothing to show everyone who crosses my path the love of my mother that is inside of me. I was right next to my mom when she passed away, and I am beyond thankful for that. She was one of the first pair of eyes I ever looked into, and I was the last pair of eyes that she looked into before she passed away. Looking into her eyes in that moment and telling her, "Do not be afraid, Mom. I love you. You can be free to go with God, and I will see you again soon," was the single most defining moment of my entire life. The last 8 months of this battle of cancer, my mom taught me to believe again, to be faithful in heaven and in powers that stand beyond this world. After the moment I shared with my mom, my complete and utter faith is derived from the fact that I know I will see my mom again. That is the only absolute jar of truth in my heart, that I will see my mom again. Before I enjoy the rest of my day with you all, I'd like to share my moment with you and a third. You may bow your heads, clasp your hands, whatever you're comfortable with, but allow yourself to feel for my mom and for her to feel for you. Hey Mom, you have offered us yet again another beautiful day. The sun shines bright for you, especially today. I wanted to let you know that I miss you dearly, but that I know you are shining down on me in heaven. I feel you. I feel your presence all around me and all around the loved ones with us right now. Like I said in the last one together, I'll say every day until I'm with you again, I will see you again. I love you, Mom. Amen. So, thank you for doing that with me. You know, it's something I wake up and do every morning. You know, periodically throughout the day, I do with my mom. To put a close on what I have to say today, my mom has brought us all together. She has taught us all how to love. That was her purpose in this life. To bring us together and to show us how to love. That is what I want to carry with me for the rest of my life. Thank you.
This time, as you can see in your program, we're going to have time, if a couple of you would like to share some brief words about Carolyn's life and her impact on you. If any of you will, you can kind of just raise your hand. We're just going to do a couple of acts. As a matter of fact, also we'll have this available for reception to be here at the Military Service. You might like to see some more. And I'll just kind of end with Dr. Flora today. So, if any of you want to share,
get news from Carolyn saying something about 1:30 or 2 o'clock in the afternoon every day. We hear, is it 5 o'clock yet? And I say, almost. But Carolyn, it's 5 o'clock.
Take care of her three boys, she took care of me and my family. And I just want to thank her for her presence in this world. She's really one of those people that reminds me that angels exist on earth with us. So thank you, Carolyn.
The memories I have of Carolyn started many years ago in the late 80s. I was her second husband's sister and father. I was the first of my life. I wanted to tell Rick and the boys, Rick, your amazing husband, even if your dad, he was supportive and loved her and the boys. Boys, you have a great mom, Derek did her justice, and you were a spoiled brother.
Father Shane. He goes, I know that's not, I'm not an educated guy. I guess I know him not very well. But I think he understands. So this went on for some time until the guy, Jim, stopped showing up. And the priest got a phone call. This is a true story. The priest got a phone call from a local home for aged men who needed housing. And it was a Catholic housing development. And the nun called the priest and said that Jim was admitted a week or two ago. And so the priest went down to see him. And the priest said, when I went down there, I talked to the sister at the front desk and I asked where Jim was. And she said, Jim, she goes, I gotta tell you, came in here a couple weeks ago. And we didn't have any room except for the most cantankerous, toxic, backbiting, mean-spirited ward of our home here. I mean, all the guys there, it's a horrible place to go. No one likes being there because they're just so angry and bitter and toxic and unforgiving. She said, we put Jim in there, and in less than 2 weeks, it's completely reversed. People are praying, they're taking care of one another, they show deference. And the nun, she goes, listen, this father, I'm going to ask Jim. She said, Jim, how is it that you bring so much joy to so people in such a short amount of time? How did you do that? And Jim looked at her. She goes, Jim looked at me and he smiled and he said, oh, sister, that's because of my visitor. The nun knew that during Jim's time there, he had not received one single visitor. Your visitor? She asked. And he said, sister, every day at 12 noon, he comes and he stands in the foot of my bed and he says, Jim, it's Jesus. And Frank Harrington tells that story, goes on to say, he said, the continuing reality of the truth of the fact, not just as a nice, comforting thing to say, but the truth of the fact that Jesus actually lives, that what happened on that first Easter meant a change in the world. And what that means, if the Bible's true, which obviously I think it is, that means that there could be a change in the way you look at life because he lives. There could be a change in the way that you look at death because he lives. There could be a change in the way that you look at every facet of your existence because he lives. That's why I suspect that she was such a bright light to a lot of you who spoke. It's because she wouldn't shine at all night. There was a light that was shining over her that she now enjoys face to face. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us now sing a great hymn of faith. Many years ago, amazing grace.
God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though waters roar and foam and mountains quake with their surge, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her, and she will not fall. God will help her at the break of day. Nations are in uproar, kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice. Lord Almighty is with us. God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see what the Lord has done, the desolations that he's brought on the earth. He makes war cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and he shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. He says, be still. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. And the God.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done.
Thank you.
plethora of them, so it shouldn't take too long. But if you just wait out there, head out there, and the Lord's service. Appreciate it. Receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you.